what Citibank says about the Bitcoin. And I think these banks better be watching their P's and Q's, because Bitcoin is coming for them with BlockFi and decentralized finance, also known as DeFi. Banks should be tripping. I'm just saying. But Michael Burry, because we have some good news and we have some bad news. Michael Burry of The Big Short, right? Guy wears some big shorts. He had a good movie. Although my wife said it was stupid. I was like, all right, babe. What, you want to watch Desperate Housewives of Texas or whatever the heck you watch? He says that Bitcoin is going to crash. GTFO. We are in a bubble. Everyone run for the hills. All these analogies, I'm thinking, okay, you're in a bubble, you're going to run into hills, I don't know, maybe you'll bounce off of the hill, because then you have Citibank that says that this thing's going to blow, and I have no blow jokes. And here we go, Bitcoin is at a tipping point and could become the currency. Wait, pause, ADHD, red ticker symbol across the stock, stocks rocket higher in broad rally to start March. S&P 500 jumps 2% for the best day since June. Hey, isn't it nice to be a swing trader, right? When everyone's like, oh, it's going to zero, and then it recovers. They're like, oh, just saying. But Bitcoin is at a tipping point and could become the currency of choice for global trade, Citibank says. And look at this young lady behind bars, right? Because that's where they want Bitcoin, behind bars, trying to get your money out. Probably Spain. Think Spain? Look, X, you see that? Just a guess. I'm a traveling man. Angela Garcia Bloomberg, Getty Images. Ugh, there it is. ATM Barcelona, Spain, 2021. All right, so here we go. Could become, this is what they're saying, become the currency of choice for international trade. And I'll tell you where I have some problems with that. I do think that it will be first layer. And that's how everything is. It will not be a currency until it is in, until it has a $1 trillion market cap. Like, bravo, it already does. Oh, all right. Okay, $2 trillion. No, it needs to be so that you don't have these high volatile swings of the percentages. You can't have a currency that's like, oh, shoot, everything just went down 20% today. Even though the dollar has gone down 98% since inception, 100 years, but things not. This currency, nothing. I mean, it's worth what it is. You just lost almost 100% of its value. So it looks like Bitcoin has that one beat. But I do see it first layer, right? You have gold, first layer. And then you can build the layers underneath that, like Visa and all of that kind of stuff. Or like back in the day, they had, what was it? Gold, right? Gold, first layer. And they're like, oh, if you have a 20, you can bring it to the bank and we'll give you your $20 gold coin. Don't you wish you could do that now? But Tricky Dick in 71 said, we're not going to do that anymore. And then from 1971 until today, the system is wrecked. And that's this channel. You got two parts doom, one part gloom. I try to throw in some happiness in there. What is right now? Currently 28%, 30% of people are just on the dole doing nothing. And I can guarantee you that that will not work, cannot work, but it has to continue forever and ever. You cannot take the cash out of baby's hands and go, no more cash for you. Stimulus forever. So I tell people, you think it's bad now? Oh, you wait. We are just a stimulus train. That's it. And I've had people on this channel that says, once you remove that stimulus, the market goes down 80%. Poof, everything. Back to crypto. Cryptocurrency is at the tipping point of mainstream acceptance or speculative implosion, the bank added. And Bitcoin's wild. It's getting all wild all over the place over the last few months. Didn't see that one coming after the halving. Kind of usually always does, but okay. Yes, and we just seem to be, now they're having to wrestle it. What do we do this? Shoot, this thing's now in a bull market. Well, come back later. It'll be in a bear market. And then we can say, oh, it's going to zero. And then you have companies, MicroStrategies. Can you guys believe this? They are now taking, this is what you do. Start up a company, okay? You don't have to produce a product. Just create a bond. These are bonds right here. Just create a bond and go, hey, anyone want to buy these bonds? And so that's what they're doing. Raising capital, selling bonds. And what do? With that said bond, they just buy Bitcoin. That's what MicroStrategy, what do they got? $4 billion. Software maker reported acquiring an additional 328 Bitcoins on the dip. And we have been in a bull market since all the way back here. What, May 1st? April 27th? Bull market. Easy to trade bull markets. And look at these swings. And these swings, they don't give you very much. I don't know if this is on the daily. Look at this swing. You get what, 20%, 30% dip, then woo, 20%, 30% dip, then woo, and here we are again. But before we do, let me just tell you, this one, I think it was 30% from top to bottom, 26.35. Just missed it. So you can go one approach where you're just on the bull market, right? You're just collecting little beans on the dips. Just a little here, little there. You know, you fund an account with $1 because you don't. Oh, and you just want to do paper trade, right? Right. Right click, trade, just sell. Do we want to sell right now? We're just going easy on this. Paper trade. I also have, this is not financial advice, right? Paper trading. You don't want to lose real money, even though Bitcoin's not real. So I guess you're really not losing anything. I have a course on this for $300, a few bucks off, 200 and something. 97 till it goes up to 397. So link in the description. Like I've said in my life, what I teach my high school kids, my students, my everything is this economy. The only way you're going to make it in life, either you get inheritance, right? Someone just gives you a whole lot of money, but then you'll probably blow it anyways. Start a business. You want to be successful? Start a business. If that one fails, you have three other ones that you started. Some of those fail, and then trade equities. That's it. Compound interest. Albert Einstein says greatest invention, eighth wonder of the world. Just keep rolling it. 10% here, 5% here, 3%. I'm down 1%. I'm up 5%. I'm down 3%. I'm up 10%. You just keep snowballing it. One of my friends, she's a nurse, and her husband's a cop, and they don't even have enough money. Well, we're in Southern California to buy a house. Can't come up with a down payment, nothing. Like, where in the world did we now get to a place where you have two people making very good incomes, cannot afford shelter and have to rent? That's why I'm like, you guys have to find a side hustle. Find a side hustle, turns into a business, copy a business. I don't care. Don't reinvent the wheel. Just make it better. Something business. All of you guys that work for jobs for a living, find something that you're doing and going, oh, I could do that and I can do it better. I think I will. And then you say, I don't have any money. Well, then borrow it from someone. That's what I did. I mean, I remember my wife at the time wasn't even old enough to consume adult beverages. And I borrowed money from someone and I bought a day spa. I know, go figure, right? And then three and a half years later, I sold that said day spa. You don't need money. You just need to use someone else's money. I figured that out a long, long time ago. And it's done very well. So borrow, just get there. But looking at this, it's going to disrupt the fire truck out of big tech, or it's gonna disrupt the fun out of big tech. One or the other, fire truck or fun. Crypto roars back as Citi sees imminent tipping point in global trade. And the answer in this story is Bitcoin has soared above 48,000 this morning, crashing, that's kind of a crush, at 42,000 handle over the weekend following Congress passing Biden's stimulus package. That is not why the Bitcoin goes up. That is not why the Bitcoin goes down. That is not why the stock market goes up or down. It has nothing to do with Biden. And just like with everything in life, it's manipulated. Gold, manipulated. Silver, manipulated. Right? I don't care. I can make money in gold. I know when to get out. I know when to get in. I've been getting out of gold. Why? Death cross. Gold's going down. But here's your manipulation in the F2 pool. Just these miners. One. Look at this. Every time they come in, boom, crash, boom, crash. All this, boom, crash. Another one. And that's when I yelled at you guys. This was before this one. I'm like, get out. We had another one. And now they're getting even actually smarter. Let me show you something. Boom, dump, another one. But now they're doing it, it's in larger scale, but smaller. So do not think that Bitcoin might not take, it's trying to get beat down right now, but you have so much good news that's pushing it up. So you have F2 pool pulling it off. They're like, okay, we'll mine it. We mine the gold out of the ground. Now what do? Let's push the price down so we can double our money. Sounds like a great idea. But then you have, on the other hand, you have companies that are selling bonds to buy Bitcoin. And miners, this is the first time since December, accumulating instead of dumping. So then here you go. Right here, I don't know if you can you see it? If I zoom in, no, that's good. You guys see that? This is actually your first green candle since late December. So I don't know, kids. Oh, and right above my head, here it is. MicroStrategy adds 15 million to its Bitcoin. They just, they keep doing it. And then Elon, Elon Musk trolls SEC with Dogecoin meme shield. Yeah, didn't Elon say, oh, it's just like, Bitcoin's like currency, it's stupid. And we got two stories right here. One story here, and then one story down there that I want to talk. Gold miners declined nearly 30%. And people are like, yes, gold miners. If I had all the money, what would I be doing? Gold mining stocks. No, I would be looking at the charts. Well, I don't care. I buy when it's cheap. How do you know when it's cheap? You need charts to tell you when it's cheap. I'm not touching gold. I'm not touching gold miners. I've been out for over a month. I warned you. I told you. I said, please, 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 please. And Goldman restarts a cryptocurrency trading desk, which back in the day, during a bear market, you really don't need to manipulate it. But now, here we go. Restarts. So here we go, kids. Back in 17, 18, they're like, wait, maybe Bitcoin is no good. Not at all. Stay away. Now we're in another bull market. They're like, let's manipulate this thing to the moon. And then on the other side of the moon, we have the sun. Unless we don't. Here's something that'll burn you. Too close to the moon, too close to the sun. Big Short investor Michael Burry slams Bitcoin as a speculative bubble and says a crash. Woo! He says it. A crash is coming, kids. Look out. And you see on my channel, you don't know what to do. You're like, should I like this video? Because I should I dislike it? No, I give you balance with everything that I do. There's just balance. That's it. I'm not a buy and hodler. You'll never catch me hodling, except for a little corn, a little gold and silver. Real estate, kind of tough to get out of, right? Those kind of assets, it's tough, even though I'm getting out of this asset. So equities, easy peasy, click a button, like, I'm in, I'm out. Oh, dip, I'm in, oh, I'm out. And I agree with Michael. Yes, Bitcoin is in a bubble. It always will be, it always has been, and a crash is coming, yes. It crashes up, it crashes down, it crashes back up, it crashes back down, and it takes everyone out. It actually even took me out. One of my last trades was that 8,300 of Bitcoin. I was like, that's it. We're now in a bear market. I will be back. And everyone's like, no, buy it. You know, I'm like, nah, I trade better up than I trade better down. Tell me that doesn't make sense. And then I was thinking, hey, maybe I should change the way I think about it, right? And just take a little bit more, you know, on the dips. Okay, I'll take a little. I take my fiat, my worthless sheets of paper. I take my fiat, and then I trade those fiat for digital coins. And just me saying digital coins makes me feel like maybe I should get out. Okay, so when he says the investor grouped it with the electric vehicles. Okay. SaaS, software as a service. I owned one of those. If you ever want to look it up, it was called Rewip, REWIP. You can see it on YouTube. It was a company I worked on, CEO for 5 years. It was amazing. Long story short, I don't want to get into the long story. He compared the boot. You're like, but I thought you were just a high school business teacher. No, every year I start new companies. Teaching's always been my side hustle. He compares the boom in these assets to the dot-com and housing bubble. So Bitcoin is just like the housing bubble, except there's only 21 million of these Bitcoin, and there's only three homes available on the market right now, which makes prices go up. So I don't know, that's probably a terrible analogy, but I tried. But I guess he thinks it's a fad. BTC, EV, SaaS, meme stocks, housing market. It's all just a fad, and then in the end, On the whole, not working, just derivative. It is. Is it a derivative? Yeah, it can be. Yeah, if you buy it on Robinhood, dummies. Just driven. But even though I did talk to the CEO from Robinhood, and he did give me his word that it would be for real at some point, that Bitcoin you could actually buy and you can put it on your wallet and you can send it to your friend's wallet. But I don't know if I buy it, Flav, but okay, even though I just said your name wrong. Just driven by speculative fever to insane heights from which the fall will be dramatic and painful, he said. And then he actually goes on to talk about Charlie Munger. Oh, that young boy. Those saying me and Munger and Singer are out of touch are not considering that we have seen all this before, not just once, but probably, well, Munger, I think he's, 184? Yeah, he's probably seen a lot. And also, why I say this is not financial advice is because we can go back 12 months, 11 months. We can go, oh, well, what did Bitcoin do? Well, it dropped all the way down to 3,000. $3,850. On what exchange, I do not know, but you only had one day. You only had minutes. I know my kids, we're all gathered around computers going, oh my gosh, did you see that? I mean, you had one day where it went from, what was it? 8,000 in one day. The next day, 3,800. The next day, yeah, not too far off from that, five. Yeah, you guys could have had it for five, four, and then it started to pop back up. Oh, wow. And even going back in time, I feel so surreal. What I did, see this indicator that I have? Sell. Why? Because we went below, right? We dropped below the 200-day moving average. That said to me, Johnny Bravo, we'll see you later. And I was not trading that. That is when I got out 8.6, 8.3, 8.8. I was hitting all the accounts all over because who knows? I even found, I showed you in a few videos back where I just, oh, hey, I left money in that. It was like 1,200. Like, okay. But yes, they are right. Speculative asset. An asset in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days. In 5 days, it loses 55% of its value. That would be frightening. You cannot have a currency lose 55% of its value. And then everyone said, no, Bravo, you can't do this. Have hands of diamonds. They're just not. I can't do much with diamond hands. I end up scratching everything. It's like some really bad movie. Although I would like to look like Johnny Depp. Well, not Johnny Depp now. The Johnny Depp back in Edward Scissorhands when he was cutting everyone's heads off. Right here. That's where I'm like, okay. I mean, if you guys want to play bear market and you have the indicators that are on, you're like, okay, I know we're in a bear market, but maybe that's frightening. I'm like, okay, one candle. Do you see this one candle? Look at this candle close. Whoop, bull market, right? Whoop, bear market. And I give you warning signs, all these warning signs. So I have been in since right there, April, little bit, right? Bull market, more, all the way. Look how far, oh gosh, this is like a terrible roller coaster. It's actually not a roller coaster. It's more like a terrible rocket ship if you have not been on it. But we actually do. One of my high school kids was like, what's the lowest it'll go? I said, well, you know, 3,800. But in this market, for it to drop down, 50%? Touch the 200-day, bounce right off of that. Even that would be frightening. Because if those bond yields take off, the market's going to freak. Don't think Bitcoin doesn't get, you know, brought along in the basket. That's what happened. Gold, silver, Bitcoin, stocks. Everyone click the sell button, right? We have to cover our positions. We need to get out. The Fed has lost control. This is just from Matt Fox. He's saying this. The Fed has lost control. And the historic spike in bond yields point to a looming stock market crash, Bank of America says. That'd actually be a very good doom and gloom video just right there with the bond yields, which I've done videos on it prior. I still think we're going in that direction. If you pull back, look at the macro, and I also believe the Fed doesn't have control. They don't. Everyone wants to make them all the gods, you know, that they are, but they're actually not. All they do is they buy bonds with their Chuck E. Cheese tokens, their Fugazi, off of the banks. That's it. The primary dealers, they're like, okay, we'll put that on our balance sheet until Congress gives them the go-ahead to monetize that debt. And they're like, okay, now we can do this. But yes, for my doom and gloomers, keep an eye on this one right here. And it doesn't look good. No. 1.42. Yeah, you probably don't want to get above one. You get this. Yes, you could. Hey, look at that. I had a channel all drawn for you. And we popped out of that. Or is that, that's on the daily. We popped out of that channel. Look at the amount of things that you can do with my trading course. Not just that. Look at this. See that? That's actually, this colorful one over here is the long-term trend. If I were to pull out, you'd see it and go, oh, what's happening there? Could this be an anomaly? Could be. I don't like that. I do not like being in a bull market on the 10-year yield. That's frightening. And what else is frightening? That would be the economy, even though no one even, you wouldn't even have guessed it, except that, what, 10%? We had a 10% income raise in January. Everyone made 10% more in January. That is just way to go, guys. And I did want to just say this because you might go, no, that's not even possible. Yes, look at this. When I said 10%, here it is. Personal income leaps 10% in January. You guys must be producing something, right? Producing like crazy. Nope. Thanks to stimulus, that is not going to go away. Inflation's still in check. We don't have an economy. All we have is a debt-based system, keeping things at zero, stagflation, nothing. And I try to sit here and give you like big picture everything. Let me give you the doom, the gloom, and the happiness in between, right? I don't know. Okay, I see this happening over here, and then I see that happening over there. I see the puck going that way. You should probably go over that way because I think the puck's going over there. And then at the end of the day, the last thing I want anyone to do is ever to lose money. To make money, That's why swing trading, I love it. Like small, little, you make your swings, you get in and out. Everyone's just so used to just buy Tesla. They don't even want to sell it. Why would I sell? I don't know. How do you even sell something? And then you never want to sell anything that's going up because you're like, it's going up. But you never want to sell anything when it's going down because you're losing money. Such a weird like trading. It's a lot mental. If you can get your head around the mental, like when I was showing you with the charts, you're like, oh, okay. But link in the description or I'll pin it so I don't screw it up. So you can have 70% off so you can figure out how to do that. So you can help yourself out. You can help your kids out, your family. You can teach them these kind of things. You can share this video. That actually helps me out a whole lot. But I would rather you help out a grandkid. They probably don't even care. They just want to watch, whatever, YouTube. As long as they're watching me, we're okay. But thank you guys so much for making it to the very end. And until tomorrow, I'll see you tomorrow.